Well, Sophie Ellis-Bextor has dominated the dance floor with her pop hits since the 90s. Now she's releasing her first book, Spinning Plates, Music, Men, Motherhood and Me. I caught up with the star to hear all about it. Congratulations on your book, Spinning Plates. What was it that inspired you to write an autobiography?
Initially, I didn't know that's what I was going to do, actually. I was approached to do a book that was going to be a series of essays. Because last year I started a podcast called Spinning Plates, and that was me talking to lots of working women who happen to be mothers about, I suppose ostensibly it's about how we make it all work. But as I started writing, I thought, oh, I think I know what I'm doing here, and I ended up just writing everything. So yeah, that's when it turned into an autobiography, really.
You cover every aspect of your life in this book. Nothing's off limits. I wonder what was the toughest topic for you to write on?
The hardest was writing about contemporary times, writing about my current situation, just because, like the chapter I wrote about my husband, I left till last because it's quite hard to write about people where you're actually very involved with them in real life.
I know you've touched on a time in your life that was very challenging. You started in the music industry at such a young age, at 17. A lot of industries have shifted drastically over the years, and a lot of that is thanks to the Me Too movement. Do you think that the music industry has had its reckoning yet?
When I was young, the way things were spoken about between right and wrong when it came to consent and a sexual dynamic turned into something that wasn't fair, I think a lot of that was quite in the grey areas, and now we're much better with articulating those nuances. So I don't know if it's even specific to the music industry. I think it's just in general equipping people with the language of what's okay and what's not okay. I think we're much better now at putting the emphasis on that.
You grew up with performance in your household. That was your upbringing. When did you decide, though, that music, that singing was going to be your path?
Kind of fell into it, really. I always adored music, but you're right, my parents both worked in TV. But really, it wasn't until I was a teenager and I got asked to sing in a band that I suddenly was like, oh, this is what I've been looking for.
I have to ask you about Murder on the Dance Floor, because that is still a party staple everywhere in the world. I wonder, when you hear it playing at the shops or at a party on a dance floor, how does it make you feel to hear that song today?
If I'm performing it, I'm on very good terms with it, but if you're out and about and you hear it, it's definitely a little bit cringy when it's your own song. But I have a rule that if I'm on a dance floor and one of my songs come on, I have to stay on the dance floor. And if I'm not on the dance floor and it comes on, I have to stay off. So I think if your song comes on and you make your way to the dance floor, that is not a good look. But if you're dancing and your song comes on and you walk off the dance floor, that is also not a good look. It's murder on the dance floor, but you
better not kill the groove. As a mother of two boys myself, I choked when I read that you have five boys. How on earth do you get through the day? How do you make it work?
I was sort of trotting along quite happily, alternating babies and albums. And then when we got into our first lockdown last year, and I suddenly look and there's these five kids aged between 1 and 16, it was a bit, oh, this is actually quite a lot I've taken on here. You just have to embrace the fact that it is going to be a constant momentum of family life. And you know, some of it's quite a lot of admin.
Laundry, so much laundry.
Oh, so much laundry.
Your kitchen discos were such a brilliant silver lining for so many people during lockdown in London. Did your boys enjoy it as much as we did?
My husband and I, we'd plan things and I'd, you know, get an idea in my head of what songs I wanted to do. But for the kids, I didn't really talk to them about it a lot because it was more in the moment. All of us used it as a place to put our stress and just jump away the tension. This was half an hour where they could dress up, jump on the sofa. We'd always have like quite a fun Friday night supper. They'd stay up a bit late afterwards.
It's not too late to change, Jess. Can you stop throwing pillows at your brother?
There are more congratulations in order because I see you have just had a cameo on Ramsay Street in Neighbours. Have you always been a fan of the show?
I thought, oh my God, that's really fun. Because in the UK, everybody grew up or grows up watching Neighbours. It's for me and my, you know, my old school friends. That was what we'd speak about when we came into school in the morning. You know, you discuss what happened in Neighbours the night before. So yeah, it's really, really good to have that on my CV now. I'm happy. You know what's really funny? When I dropped the kids at school this morning, one of the mums said to me, oh, you're back quick. And I went, back from where? And she went, we've just been to Australia, haven't you? You went to Ramsay Street. It's like, oh no, that was actually in London. But...
and now you're talking about it at the school gate again.
Exactly.
You've been back on stage in recent weeks. Could we perhaps see you touring down under anytime soon?
I'd love to come back. I've had such happy times in Australia. So yeah, somebody book me and I'll come. The last time I came, I went when my five-year-old was just born, and I had two gigs, a Friday night in Sydney and a Saturday night in Melbourne. So I took him and we went for the weekend. So I landed in Sydney on Friday, did the gig, flew to Melbourne on Saturday, did the gig, and then on the Sunday, flew all the way home again.
Next time, though, you have to stay for more than 2 days.
That would be ideal, yeah. It was a little bit extreme.
Thank you so much for your time, Sophie. It's so lovely chatting with you.
Yeah, same to you. And I hope your little boys give you a peaceful night. Crying at the
discotheque. Oh, what a great chat.
Isn't she gorgeous? Spinning Plates is out now. She's so cool. She really keeps it real. She's got this podcast called Spinning Plates. And it's no wonder it's an enormous success because she is so relatable, isn't she? Everyone can understand. I mean, and how much fun does her house look?
Oh, what a great mum. It was a lovely, terrific. lovely chat.
Thank you, Dickie.